Hi, I'm Dr. Tracy Marks. I'm a psychiatrist and psychotherapist, and I want to give you a tip about antidepressants and dreams. This is intended to be educational and not designed to be treatment or personal medical advice to you. So have you ever taken Prozac, Zoloft, Lexapro, any kind of psychiatric medication or antidepressant and notice that you have really intense dreams, almost nightmarish type quality? Well, it's not a coincidence. Antidepressants suppress REM sleep. What's REM sleep? Rapid eye movement sleep is a phase of sleep that we all go through where we do our dreaming. Antidepressants, for whatever reason, suppress or decrease the amount of REM sleep that we have, which can result in rebound REM. Think of it as having REM or something that you're stuffing down into a pot. Let's say a pot on a stove that's boiling and you're trying to hold the top on and it's barely coming, staying on, and then boom, it blows. That's kind of what happens. You stuff down your dream sleep and then boom, you have these really intense dreams. There's nothing dangerous about it. In fact, some sleep doctors, for example, treating sleep apnea will take advantage of the fact that, or take advantage of the REM suppression, because for those who have most of their sleep apnea episodes during REM sleep, it can actually decrease those episodes. So if you're someone with obstructive sleep apnea, for example, it may be beneficial for you. Now, you'll have to deal with the intense dreams and things, but just keep in mind that that's not something that is dangerous necessarily, and it's not anything that means that something weird is happening to your brain. The suppression of REM sleep isn't anything that's some permanent damage to you. So that's the deal with weird dreams and taking antidepressant medications. If it's something that you don't like, well, you can switch medications, and not all of them do it to the same degree. In general, as a class, they do it, but the effect or how it manifests can vary from person to person and from medication to medication. So just know that it's not something that's dangerous, but if it is something that you just can't deal with, try taking a different one in the same class and see if that makes a difference for you. Thanks for listening.